Here we are. It's good to be back home. It's time to get some fresh air and a nice, nice cup of coffee. Now that sounds absolutely perfect.
Doctor! Doctor, are you there? It's me, Sam! Open up! It's you! I know it's you! Please, open up!
Hang on a minute! I'm coming! Well, hello. And... you're hugging me a little too tightly, I think.
Sorry.
Well, that's rather an enthusiastic way of saying hello, right? Certainly for a first meeting.
You're not him. You're not the doctor. Doctor, where are you?
I am the doctor. Is there something I can do for you?
It's you. You've regenerated. But that means you died, didn't you? And you came back. Did you die trying to cross the void? You trying to come here? You shouldn't have done that. I mean, for me.
I see. Well, this is certainly a bit awkward.
No, it's all right. I've gotten used to the change already. Your new face, it's bolder, and your voice is more like an American, but it's fine, really. What's important is that it's you, and you're back.
Did you just call me old? As a matter of fact, I am nowhere near old. Mature, maybe, a bit serious at times, but definitely not old. Anyway, do you even know what you are talking about?
I told you, it doesn't matter. You look okay, really. I don't mind. Honestly.
You don't mind? Now that doesn't sound like a compliment at all. You see, time travel can be exceedingly strange at times. Especially when you meet a person whom you haven't yet had the pleasure of meeting. Let's start this again. I am the doctor. And what is your name?
Samantha.
Samantha? Sam. There's an echo of familiarity there. Not a memory exactly, but definitely an echo. Yes, I think it's quite probable that we will have met at some point in my future. Most probably my linear future. It gets all confusing sometimes.
An echo? That's all you remember, an echo? You don't remember us? You don't remember anything that we did? Oh, of course not. You can't remember because it hasn't happened yet. You're an earlier version of him, a past self. So how did you get here? You said the Timelords were all dead and that they couldn't open up a gateway and that it's impossible now to travel between parallel universes.
First of all, nothing is impossible. But I'm afraid I don't quite follow. I haven't crossed the void, at least not to get here anyway. What do you mean about the Timelords being dead? Who told you such nonsense?
How can you not know? Unless you're not my doctor. You're like this universe's doctor. That's it, isn't it?
Absolutely fascinating. Sam, explain to me again. What do you mean by the Time Lords being dead?
They were all killed in a war. The Time War. You... well, he is the only one left in his universe. My universe.
You're not from this universe. Now that is very interesting. But you have one thing wrong. Nothing can destroy the Time Lords. Neither here nor there. Of that, I am absolutely sure.
I probably shouldn't have mentioned it, I know, but in my world, in my universe, there aren't any Time Lords left except you. Look, I knew you, him, as well as anyone, I think, and he wouldn't have lied to me. And if you're him, you know that.
All these years traveling through time and space, and not once have I encountered this. Well, it's been some time since I've been home. It's a stuffy, boring old planet. Not interesting in the least, but still, it was home. I should stop by and say hello. Perhaps have a look around. See if anything is... oh, no, this is absolutely ridiculous. Still, I think I will go just in case.
I'm coming with you.
But I am not your doctor.
I know you're not him. It doesn't matter. He's never coming back. He can't. He told me so himself. He told me goodbye. Him and I, we had a laugh, but it's over. You're not him, I know. But you are the doctor, and this is the TARDIS, so I belong here. I'm coming with you, and that's final.
I can't change your mind. You are absolutely decided, then?
Yes.
Good. I do hate traveling alone. Come on, Sam. We've got work to do.
am again, taking off across the universe with a man I don't even know. And I've left them all behind. Again. Without even a second thought. I am sorry, Mom.
So sorry to disturb you.
Doctor!
Alright, I need to ask you a question. In your travels with the other doctor, did you ever happen to acquire a transtemporal passport? It's just that we're at the border and, you see...
No, I haven't got a transtemporal passport. I've got an Irish passport, but that's at home.
That complicates things a bit.
Look, do you mind? I'm in the bath.
Oh, right. Sorry. I forgot. Gotta go. Yes, the TARDIS has been in my control. Well, most of the time anyway, but that is all in the past or future, but I digress. Yes, I am traveling with a non-Gallifreyan. No, she doesn't have a passport. Look, she constitutes no threat to advanced civilizations. Human, yes. That's right, human. H-U-M-A-N. Homo sapien, Earth. Yes, I will hold. Fat, useless bureaucrats. Blowing them up would be a public service. Oh, hello, Sam.
Are we going to be able to get through?
Yes, of course. But unless I get some strings pulled, I'm foreseeing complications. You are, after all, an alien.
Do I look like an alien? You're the alien.
Well, yes, but...
And is it a Gallifreyan custom to walk in on someone in the bath?
It's not entirely inconceivable that on rare occasions I might err on personal etiquette. All right. Ah, yes, good. Listen, tell her we will see her as soon as we arrive. It does help to have a few connections. Chancellor Romana took care of everything. But there is one very tiny complication.
What?
Just, a formality, really.
What formality?
It's nothing. Nothing at all. Just a minor inconvenience.
What inconvenience?
You have got to go through customs. Ah, there you are. That didn't take long, did it? Not too terrible, I hope.
That was a minor inconvenience.
Well, I haven't actually been through the process myself, of course, but I understand.
I've been probed, prodded, scanned, scrubbed, and scraped. I've had everything searched, and I mean everything. They took blood samples, saliva, sweat, hair, and skin.
I never knew it was that thorough. They must be getting a bit nervous these days. I wonder why. Let's go then. The capital is this way.
How tall are these doors? 20? 30 feet?
Grandstanding. Typical Timelord manner.
Hello, Doctor. Welcome home.
Ah, Romana. So good to see you. You look lovely as ever. It seems like only yesterday that we were searching for the key to time. I do miss those days. We had such a wonderful and great time, didn't we?
You didn't do so bad yourself. Tell me, who is your friend?
Oh, this is Sam. She claims an acquaintance with my dimensional double. Actually, rather more than an acquaintance, I think.
Another doctor? That certainly could complicate things. Sounds interesting. You'll have to tell me all about it sometime.
Sure. Lots to tell.
I am sure. Well, this place certainly hasn't changed much at all. Wait, what in the blazes is that by the back wall? It can't be. The shield of Rassilon. It must be a copy.
No, it is the real thing.
But how? It was destroyed.
We have found a proof for Eulenberg's conjecture.
That's ridiculous.
Not if you correct for multiversional dimensional flux.
What are you two talking about?
She means it's now possible to travel through Gallifrey's early history. Which, of course, is impossible.
You said nothing is impossible.
Well, this one is.
We do it mostly for archaeological purposes, you understand. We snatch important artifacts moments before they are destroyed. We're reluctant to do anything else.
Yes, quite.
In any case, it is certainly a coincidence you are here. We were about to summon you, but it proved unnecessary.
Summon me? Why?
You haven't heard, then, about the contagion? No, I suppose not. You're always off exploring, always oblivious to what happens here at home.
You, of all people, should know that.
No matter. We caught the man behind it, and he's safely in custody. An old acquaintance of yours, actually.
Who?
The Master.
Him again? Ugh, one of these days my patience with that sorry excuse for a Time Lord shall run out.
I expect you'll want to see him now, then.
No, not really. What a tedious way to spend an evening. I've far more important things to do than attend to a bore.
Such as?
Why, dinner with two beautiful young ladies. Speaking of which, how old are you now, Romana? 400? 5? Oh, don't say 6. 6 is such an awkward age.
I am 273, thank you very much.
Are you really? Amazing. You don't look a day over 300.
I see your sense of humor hasn't improved much.
Tell me about the contagion.
It started at the academy. The whole archaeological team was suddenly taken ill. Well, naturally, we assumed something had gone wrong with the temporal calculations. But then we caught the Master trying to steal the shield of Rassilon. He confessed to using a bioweapon to cause chaos, so that he could get into the artifact room. He has thus far been reluctant to provide us with the antidote, despite our best efforts to, persuade him. So far, no one has truly recovered, and half have died.
Died? You mean died, then regenerated?
No, died. 50% mortality at least, maybe more. Somehow the contagion also affects the regeneration gene in Timelords. That's why we were going to summon you. Then the outbreak ceased. You showed up anyway. Perfect timing as usual.
I am terribly sorry.
It's been a bit chaotic lately. Well, excuse me, I seem to be getting a bit tired. I hope you don't mind if I take my leave.
No, not at all. I'll walk you back to your room. Sam, why don't you find our assigned quarters? Follow this path down and make a first left. I'll be along in a minute, all right? And please, don't wander off.
Yes, boss.
Tell me, Romana. I've been wondering. Where is K-9? I've been thinking that...
Okay, first left should be right about there.
No. No.
Hey, what's going on? What happened?
Get away! Get away!
You're a guard, right? Are you alright?
Daleks, they're everywhere. They're killing all the Time Lords. There's no escape. We're doomed.
What? There are no Daleks here. It's just us. You're safe. You're having a nightmare or something.
Exterminate! Exterminate! Exterminate!
Help! Someone's just collapsed! Doctor!
Stand aside. You two, place him in the med carrier. Did you touch him?
Yes, I think so. Yes.
Sam, are you all right?
You there. Stop. She is under quarantine.
Quarantine?
Took you long enough.
Do you know her?
Yes, she's...
human?
Yes, of course. She is, my friend.
Doesn't stand a chance.
What are you talking about, man?
Look, she's got a primitive immune system. She'll be dead in a few hours. We can't take her to the med facility. It's too crowded. We can only admit someone who's got a chance of survival.
Not if I have something to say about it. She is a guest of Chancellor Romana. I would suggest you find her the proper accommodation. Understood?
All right. But first, we must keep her here for the medbot evaluation. Standard extra Gallifreyan procedure.
Doctor, help me.
We're going to need to seal this area off.
Doctor, don't let them keep me here. Doctor!
Sam, you must hold on. I will find out what happened. Just hold on.
What are these machines? Wait. Stay away. No. Don't touch me. No!
I heard you were here. Knew you'd come down eventually. Here to gloat?
No. But after being thrown into a black hole, most people have the decency to die. But you just refuse to go away.
I never liked dying. Old habit, I guess.
I see that they have made some improvements to your face.
Torture. Yes, they've been torturing me. Cold, starvation, beatings. Usual Time Lord hospitality.
You tire me. If anyone deserves this treatment, it is you. Not my style, of course. End this. End your suffering. Give me the antidote.
Are the Time Lords dying? Friends of yours, I hope.
Yes, friends of mine. What do you want?
I want to be free of this place. And since you are asking, I want the shield of Rassilon.
Why the shield?
You know so little. The shield is rumored to be the ultimate weapon. Oh, by the way, you're not looking so well at all.
What are you babbling about?
Pallor and fatigue, Doctor. Those are the very first symptoms of the contagion, or didn't you know that? I've dreamt of so many ways of killing you, but this is almost tragic. The celebrated doctor brought down by a microbe. Oh, the irony. However, now that I think of it, I am not ready to lose my most worthy adversary. No, not like this. Help me escape, and you'll have your antidote.
What kind of fool do you think I am?
A desperate one. If not for yourself, then for your friend, perhaps.
Hold it right there. That's far enough. Now give me the antidote.
Here it is. Proof of my intentions. But don't betray me just yet. You'll need my instructions to open it.
Have it your way. For now.
Help me open this rusted gate. It's stuck. Push. There. Now, the antidote. To open, put your hand on either side of the tube and twist.
This is a trick. I know I'm going to regret this.
In that prison, Doctor, I was tortured. The experience has given me, shall we say, a new perspective. There has been too much suffering here already. No more Time Lords need to die. Use the antidote.
It was a transmit device. Very clever. Ugh.
Ah, he's coming around.
Nurse bots.
that what they're called?
Sam, you're alive.
Yeah, sort of. No thanks to you. Where were you last night? You ditched me.
No, I didn't. I was trying to find... Well, all right, yes. I suppose I did. But it didn't go as planned. The important thing is, you're alive. How?
I don't know. I was sick, really sick all night, and then I was better.
Just like that. Very interesting. Oh.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. Couldn't be better.
Doctor, can you hear me?
Everything's collapsing. Parallel pressure. Our universe, it's in danger. Must find out.
Delirium. Give the antitoxin time to work. Just a minute or two and he'll be just...
Right. Well, where was I? Oh, hello. I'm the Doctor. What's your name?
I'm the Doctor. Dr. Caligarian. I'm your physician.
You're a doctor, but I'm the doctor. Big difference. But I ramble. Tell me everything you know about the virus.
Well, we've only just figured it out. It's a worm.
A worm?
Worms, yes. Microscopic worms. Parasitic chelentropods. Millions of them. They enter through the skin, migrate through the bloodstream, and then reside in the guts, secreting a neurotoxin. Then they reproduce and exit through the skin again.
Sounds very nasty. So why can't you kill them? Use some sort of anti-worm medicine.
Well, we're able to block the neurotoxin, for a short while at least. But eradicating the worms themselves is difficult. Once they're in the gut, they encapsulate far enough from any blood vessel that it's difficult for intravenous medication to penetrate. And any toxin strong enough to kill the worm kills the patient too.
I was under the impression ours was a highly advanced technological society. Yet you can't kill a worm.
Yes, well, you see, there hasn't been an epidemic on Gallifrey for thousands of years, and no one on staff has ever had any experience treating an infectious disease, much less a parasite. Until very recently, all I ever had to do was set the occasional broken bone.
She made a full recovery in a matter of hours. Explain it.
What, the human? I can't explain it. Humans have a very primitive immune system. Yet
she has fared better than a Time Lord. There is only one logical conclusion.
Counselor Romana! Her life sign readings are unstable!
If only I'd been able to get the antidote. If I hadn't allowed the Master to escape.
What do you mean the Master escaped?
He used the transmit beam.
Why don't you just reverse it with your sonic screwdriver? You did it on Deep Space Nine Station.
With my sonic screwdriver? How would you... It doesn't reverse transmit beams.
My doctor could do it.
My doctor could do it. Well, smarty pants, let me see it then. Show me.
What?
Told you.
Well, you know, I think you and I will get along just fine. And you, your plan seems to have backfired. Now give me the damn antidote.
The antidote. There isn't an antidote.
You would unleash an epidemic and not have the antidote.
I didn't unleash it. I had nothing to do with it.
You ignorant savage. Your lie may have cost the lives of hundreds of Time Lords.
We have you surrounded. Now down on the floor. 37, put him in binds.
Guards, take him away. Please make sure he does not get away this time.
Sorry about that. Please, now tell me how this epidemic started.
Very first cases were the entire temporal archaeological team. The team that journeyed 2 million years into our past and brought back the Shield of Razzlon.
The Shield? Of course.
So it's some kind of bioweapon?
No. A bioweapon kills indiscriminately. Razzlon would never have made such a thing. Caligarian, remember what you said about Sam, her primitive immune system? A primitive one might be just the thing to battle primitive parasitic worms. Parasites so primitive that we don't even think to scan for them on the TARDIS biofilters. Parasites that perhaps just happened to hitch a ride on Razzlon's shield. Caligarian, she went through customs. Her blood prior to the infection is on file. Check for the differences. Something is bound to turn up.
Yes, of course. Why did I not see that? Human, come here.
My name's Samantha.
Please, I need some of your blood.
What are those?
Well, there are only one or two of these cells in your custom sample, but they're everywhere in your current one. These cells are part of your autoimmune system. They expanded to fight off the infection. But I don't recognize this cell type. I don't believe it. Yes. Yes! Esophiliads!
What's an esophili...
Esophiliads! They used to be responsible for scores of asthma-related regenerations in Timelords, until we had them removed from our genome.
And that helps us how, exactly?
They only cause asthma in civilized societies, when they can't do their real job. See all those toxic granules? Esophiliads migrate right next to their prey and release them. They attack parasites, worms, search and destroy.
Sample strand verified. Please enter process code. Process complete.
Well, here it is, but I don't know if species variation might make it as lethal as the worm.
Here, let me see. Well, no time like the present.
No, I haven't tested it yet.
You were the first stranger to ever see the ceremony of Gandelman. Try not to snore.
How truly exciting.
Well, it was touch and go there for a while, but what a genius idea, Doctor. A real stroke of brilliance.
Thank you, Chancellor. Oh, there's Romana. Sam, I need to speak with her before we leave. I'll be back in a moment. Wait here.
And I want to thank you, young lady. Remember, you will always be welcome here in our beloved city. If you shall ever need our help, just ask, and we shall provide you with what we can. And do keep an eye on that companion of yours. I've known him since he was a child, you know. He was always different. Special, you might say. A lucky one is she who catches his eye.
Thank you, Chancellor. I surely will. Oh, hello. And you are?
Hello. My name is Ritzt Dwerden. Would you be so kind as to follow me to our labs? There is some additional information we require of you. Standard medical procedure, you understand.
Again? All right.
Now, where is she? Sam? Sam? She has wandered off. Huh. Why do they always wander off?
These humans you like to travel with are mere children, and children wander. The fault is yours for never looking after them properly.
I'm so glad you could help us. And now you'll be spending a great deal of time here as my, our guest. Sit down.
This is a TARDIS. Why have you brought me here? Who are you?
You may call me the Master.
Master?
Has a nice ring to it, don't you think?
No. Let me out of here. Now! Oh!
No. No, my dear. There's no need to be rude.
Take me back! Right now!
In time, little one, in time. I've one or two things to attend to first.
Like what?
Oh, exacting a bit of revenge here and there. The Time Lords tortured me. I shall do something in return. An eye for an eye. A reasonable exchange.
Oh, what is wrong with you people? Always planning and scheming. How immature.
Time Lords, they need to disappear. Disappear, do you hear me? And I will not stop till they are all gone. Every single one.
If you want a universe without any Time Lords, it's simple. All you have to do is kill yourself. There. No more Time Lords.
Is that so? I do love sarcasm. Now shut up before you anger me.
I'll find a way to stop you.
He has often managed it, but not always. And with this shield, I will destroy his most powerful weapon.
He never carries a weapon.
What the Time Lords do not realize is that this is not only a shield, but a psionic transference unit. It defends against psychic attacks, but with a little manipulation on my part, it can destroy a Time Lord's mind utterly, or more precisely, his memory.
You're mad.
Perhaps. But the Doctor can only defeat me if he remembers the future. It has taken me a very long time to work it out, but the reason he always seems to hit upon the right solution, the reason he, despite impossible odds, always seems to prevail, how he manages to interfere and thwart my plans despite my vastly superior intellect, is that he can remember what is going to happen. He remembers his future. He doesn't remember it consciously, of course, but the talent is sufficient that he can usually guess the right course of action. In any case, even if altering his mind doesn't do the trick, I have other means.
But why am I here?
It will distress the Doctor tremendously when he discovers I've taken his companion. Especially you.
You're wrong. We've only just met. He won't miss me much. In fact, he probably won't even notice I'm gone. I don't mean anything to him.
Wrong on three, Sam. I realize it's only been a few days, but surely you know me better than that.
Doctor! It's you! I mean, how did you find me here?
You didn't really think that I would allow him to escape a second time without putting a homing beacon on his TARDIS, do you?
Certainly a brilliant maneuver, but wrong move, Doctor.
What was all that nonsense you spouted about my remembering the future? You might try to remember the past. You can never beat me. Except, of course, when I fell from the radio tower. But I came back, didn't I?
Brave words. However, with this device, I will rip your mind away piece by piece.
Others have tried, but to no avail. Tell me, why do you always talk so much?
Doctor, grab the shield!
Ah, Rassilon's ultimate weapon. The best offense is a perfect defense. I knew there was a reason I was fond of Rassilon.
Come here, girl.
Doctor! Oh.
Throw down that shield now, or I kill her right here.
Don't do it, Doctor! The shield, it's off!
Wyatt!
I am putting it down. Don't do anything rash.
Some part of me is sorry to see it all come to an end. It has been a great, great match.
You're right. I can't stop you this time. But they can.
What? What is this? No! Damn you!
Nurse bots! How did you...
I might have reprogrammed them ever so slightly.
Are you coming with us?
Oh, no. I traveled with the Doctor once, but that was a very long time ago. The best years of my life, actually. But now Gallifrey needs me.
Where's my TARDIS? I left it right here.
Oh, that's a surprise. A token of our gratitude. We fixed the chameleon circuit with the latest upgrade. It is now completely invisible.
Invisible? But I didn't want the circuit fixed. I like the police box. It's my favorite thing. Oh, you know that, Romana. How am I supposed to find it?
You'll manage, I'm sure. Don't be a stranger. Goodbye, Doctor. Goodbye, Sam.
You know, you're getting back at me for all the times I beat you in chess. Oh, oh, damn.
Doctor! Where are you?
I'm right here. Watch your step.
I have a question.
All right, what is it?
I still don't understand where all those parasites that caused the epidemic came from. It was something to do with the shield, I know, but you know it wasn't a bioweapon.
All right. One of the perils of time travel is that sometimes you pick up hitchhikers. Only in this case, the parasites were hitchhiking a ride on Rassilon's shield. You see, 2 million years ago, I suspect they were everywhere. But Gallifreyans back then had a natural immunity to them. But since then, the parasites died out and consequently, our immunity waned. So there you have it in a nutshell. An enemy from the past, sort of. Simple, but complicated.
Okay.
Now, where to? Enough of boring old Gallifrey. How about...
I have another question. What is parallel pressure? You talked about it when you were delirious.
It is a property of parallel universes. Every so often, a significant decision is made. When a big event happens, it draws itself into the void and may create a parallel universe. Sometimes temporary. The thing is, most events turn out pretty much the same in the end. So the divergent parallel universes eventually collapse together again, driving out the void. Are you with me so far?
Yes. Sort of.
Much larger events, however, such as the death of the Timelords in one universe, creates a sort of pressure on an adjacent parallel universe. Pressure for a similar event to occur in that adjacent universe, so that they collapse together again in the future. I was concerned that the contagion was a manifestation of this pressure, perhaps leading to the weakening and death of Time Lords in this universe.
But if the Time Lords are alive in the other universes and mine is the only one where they're gone, shouldn't the pressure be in the opposite direction? I mean, shouldn't there be pressure for the Time Lords to return?
Very good. Very, very clever. Yes, and that is a happy thought.
I've one more question.
I had a feeling you might.
It's something the Master said. Can you really remember the future?
What a preposterous idea. You are a very, very silly girl, Samantha Morgan.
Well, I just thought... Wait a minute. I never told you my last name is Morgan.
Of course you did.
When?
Just now.
Talk to her.
This has been a Solaris audio production. Doctor Who Legacy, Homebound, starring Julian Bane as the Doctor, Caroline Morahane as Samantha, Laura Post as Romana, Philip Weber as the Master, Nicholas Rowley as Dr. Caligarian, Darren Marlar as the Medical Officer, Glenn Hibbert as Kronos, Thomas Barnes as Guard Number 1, Linwood Riley as the Guard Captain, and Audio Elan as the Computer. Produced and written by Julian Bane. Sound design, music, and post-production by Eric Busby. Adapted from an original story by Tinuviel Beren. This is the continuing adventures of the Doctor from the Doctor Who Alternate Empire series. Doctor Who is a registered trademark and copyright BBC Worldwide. No copyright infringement is intended. With special thanks to Eric Busby and DarkerProjects.com. Thank you for listening.